Nigeria, from EKTV, in the heartbeat of the Southwest. We break your day on EKTV Daybreak Nigeria, with inclusive information, news without prejudice, well-articulated reportage, in-depth news analysis, newspaper highlights, business news, sports. Watch EKTV Daybreak Nigeria from 8 to 10 morning, Mondays, Tuesdays, and Thursdays. EKTV Daybreak Nigeria, your agenda setting program.
Yes, thank you very much for joining us, and you're welcome on the first discussion segment of Daybreak Nigeria. Like we told you, we'll be having the Old Students Association, well, the executive of the Old Students Association of Ekiti State Government College. Now, we had this conversation before we came in. Some said it's Ushi, some said it's Usi. They know it as Ushi, but it's been said that it is Usi. So whichever one you hear, Usi or Ushi, they're both right, I hope. So we have the Old Students Association here, and led by the president, Mr. Olabanji Fabi. Thank you very much for joining us on the program.
Yeah, thank you for having us. Good morning, good people of Ekiti State.
And we also have the Vice President, Mrs. Fumilayo Adeyemo.
Thank you, madam. Good morning, everyone.
Yes, I'm not alone. I have my colleague, BC Oluwashona. Yes, 1999 sets of Ekiti State Government College, All Student Association. Recently, I think about last week, you had a program where you gave some awards to some deserving students. And I think some of your teachers, you recognize them for their hard work and diligence. Now, Mr. Olabanji Fabi, I'll ask you this. Is this the first time that you will be doing such?
Yeah, thank you, madam. This is not the first time, actually. I think this is the second time we'll be giving back to our alma mater. The first one we did was in 2019, where we sunk a borehole within the school premises. We discovered that the school is lacking in some basic amenities such as water. In those days when we were in school, we always go miles to fetch water. So we need to solve that problem. We have to do something about it. So we decided as a family, as in the Old Student Association of Ekiti State Government College, 1996, we decided within ourselves that if we pass through that in those days, so these current students shouldn't be doing that now. So what can we do to correct that abnormality that happened then? So we decided to sink a borehole, and by the grace of God, as I went there last some days ago, the borehole is functioning. And based on the testimony by the PTA chairman, they were so happy that the students don't have to go far again to fetch water. So I think we solved a problem at that level. And last week, we also went back to the school to give out like a prize to the students that actually did well in their studies, because we felt that it's good to encourage people, even as old as we are. When you do something and you are being acknowledge and recognize for doing it, it spoils you to want to do more. So we felt that we need to go back to the students, encourage them, acknowledge them, and recognize what they are doing. So to ginger them to do more, to be more proactive in studies, and I can say no as a fountain of knowledge. So I think we feel that that's the best way of giving back to the school.
All right, Mrs. Adeyemo. Yeah, now, is this the 1999 set did this? Yes. Is it just the 1999 set, or you brought in other, you know, the other sets? Did you bring them in to do this project?
No, the program was anchored by the 1999 set. Well, we did add last year, a lot of sets were encouraged to do same, and they actually came up with one project or the other. But so far, we're the one that started, and we've been a pioneer, you know, initiator, and we improvise the idea. And we have been having different sets coming up with one project or the other. Even after leaving there on Thursday, and that set came on Saturday to deliver.
All right, thank you very much. And let me go now to the president of the student union now. Now, you talk about we the other time, and I'm very sure that we that you are talking about might not be all the members of your set. Now, how many people do we have there? And if you have not been able to get in touch with others, what effort are you making to ensure that you have a full house?
Yeah, thanks so much for that question. Actually, we started the family, we call it U99 family, 1999, so that's why we coined the name U99. We don't want association, organization, because we believe we are family. So we call it U99 family. When we graduated, I think we were almost 240 that wrote white that finished from that school. But you know, in between that 1993 when we started and 1999 that we graduated, some left, some came in, you know, it's normal. Some leave after a session, some did 3 years and left. But we were not actually looking at maybe you must graduate, you must start, you know, we're trying to push everybody together in as much you were part of that journey from 1993 to 1999. So far, we have over 205 registered members as we speak. And all of us are spread across the world, in US, in Canada, we are all part of this program. So all we sit trying to see how far, because we don't really have everybody on board. As I said, 247 of us graduated, and in between some left, some came back, and you know. So we sit trying everything possible within our power to bring everybody on board. But the little we are having, I won't call it little, you know, when you have over 200, you know, it's much. So we are doing everything possible, we are working together, you know, the family is moving, the way we are giving back to the school, we're also looking at ourselves. Because if we don't grow, there's no way we want to give back to the school. So we are all working together as a family. We are doing things together. So it's a very good family, I would call it.
Mrs. Adeyemo, now you said you gave out some awards to some teachers and students. Now, what was the criteria for you giving out those awards? Do you give it to every teacher, or you gave it to some deserving teachers? And if you did, what was the criteria?
Because what we did last year was basically on the project, we decided to touch some individuals. And on doing that, we have to come up with the idea of giving the best student in each subject award. And not just SS3, we started from GSS1 to SS3 to ensure that everybody benefited from the project. And not only that, to encourage them so that they can do more and they can brace up to do better. Because, you know, when you are encouraged, like you said, when you are encouraged and motivated, you tend to push further and ensure your level of excellence is being highly rated. So that's why we decided to touch everybody. And the teachers that we gave were outstanding teachers who actually taught these students and made the best out of them, actually pushed them, you know, like we have challengers. We have pushers, people who pushes you to fulfill a certain level of destiny and discover potentials. So we appreciate these unique traits in every teachers that come up with outstanding students and give them award. We also gave some of our old teachers who we also benefited from their reservoir of wisdom and knowledge. We gave them award to appreciate them that even though we've been apart, we still appreciate the legacy they leave behind. And to also encourage them that their name is written on the side. I mean, in the sand of time, and that we continue to appreciate them for their outstanding performance and impact they've made in our lives.
All right, I'm still with you.
Yes, but you know what? When she was talking about teachers, I kept on wondering. Now, you gave some teachers. Now we have so many teachers.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that create like a sort of envy, rivalry between the teachers?
Actually, we almost experienced that when we went to the school.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what we did was like, we are not in the school. We don't actually know what is happening.
And
how do we?
Okay, you are not the one that's selected. The one
we gave the school management.
Okay.
We only told them that we're looking at the most punctual teacher, the male and the female. The best dressed teacher, male and female, the most committed teacher, male and female. So we gave the assignment to the school management to determine. So they are the one that came out with the name and told us, so teachers. So this is what they did. And while giving the award, it showed that they've done a very great job. because while calling them out, the way the students were applauding them, so you know that actually they've actually made a good journey, so they confirmed what they actually did. So it was a very rosy thing, and as in the hall was like everyone was just clapping.
So I think that would spur the other teachers.
Exactly. I think that's what we are trying to achieve. We want to see how we can like, yo, this social person. He got you 99 award last year. This year, I want to get it. Because we're like looking at it, we want to sustain, we want to make it a sustainable thing. Like it will be yearly thing, like we told them. So we want to make it in the form that it will be like a competition within them. Oh, I want to strive hard so that what social person got last year, I will be the one to get it this year. So that's the atmosphere we're trying to create.
Okay, Mr. Adeyemo, I'm very sure when you look at 1999 and talking about 2021, I think we have so many years between the year we are talking about, and there are so many things then that you think or you might think that it should be provided for you when you are in school then. Now, between now and then, what are some of the things that you think as you know, as emerge?
We actually entered the system 1993, right. And then we were young. The oldest among us should be around 12 years because we were young. And then before you did the day, Unity was highly glorified name, and the school was everywhere. You discovered that a lot of people from Lagos and different places, they used to come to Unity. Everybody wanted their, you know, children to be part of the system. So there was a kind of encouragement, and at the same time, a kind of, you know, there is nothing that has advantages that doesn't have disadvantages. But I realized that then we had large number of students, but now the number of students has been reduced. Basically, a lot of private schools and some other things has hijacked that goodwill from them. But the truth is that Unity has always been a wonderful, you know, school. And when we were there, of course, we have different people from different backgrounds. Some of us actually came from a low background, some came from the average, some with high degree of affluence. So we face the challenges. Sometimes it raises your self-esteem, sometimes it encourages you, sometimes it makes you to dream bigger. So I think that now, most of the people there, they are from the same environment. I think that is a minus, because people that motivate us, we realize then that people that, you know, my brother knows, we're actually from Ekiti, so, and the longest journey we ever embark on is coming to Ado Ekiti, because we're from Mobadu government, we are presiding from Igogo Ekiti, and, you know, our parents stay there, so we don't have any
place. So you are not exposed.
Holiday, yes. Okay. So when we see people coming from Lagos, we'll always see them as being champions. When they talk, we keep quiet. I remember then, Banji, that they were asked, like, don't speak vernacular and this and that. And we that we have been used to our dialects, we keep quiet because we don't want to spend our money, you know, on the penalty attached to it. So we realize that even academically, we are better. But in the time of expression and communication, we couldn't match up there. Okay. So that's why we actually made up our mind that we're going to groom that trait and tendency and ensure that in future we'll be able to face our society.
Okay, now, when you were talking, you said something, Unity. Was it called Unity School when you were there?
Yes, then it was All Saints Unity Secondary School.
Okay.
It was actually established in 1985.
Okay.
We happen to be the ninth set of the school. But when Ekiti State, then it, we had nine Unity Secondary Schools all over on those states. Mm-hmm. One in Nushi, Ekiti, Oye Ekiti, Kere Ekiti, Ado Ekiti, Akure, Owo, I think Ekwimi Akoku, and Ondo. So those nine Unity Schools spread across on those status at that time. And if you look at it that time, you know, it was always a dream of every parent to send their words to Unity. But when the Ekiti State was created out of Ondo State, so, you know, like, the government came, like, it can't continue being Unity because we have Unity in Ondo State. So it was then the name was changed to Ekiti State Government College. So many of us, even up to now, we still call ourselves Unity, because we're used to the name. That's at that time when DS3. But tomorrow, you see, you need Unitarian. But we don't really know how to the state government, how to, like, is it collegian? We call ourselves. So, like, Unitarian. So the name has It's a name that really carry. You know, when you go, like, oh, well, Unitarian. So that's why we still find it difficult to leave that name, Unity. That's why you can see.
It's just like Osua. Some went to Osua. They call it X. Some call it Osua. There's no way you can change it. Nah. They still call it
Osua. Some people tell you, no, I didn't go to X. I went to Osua. Some people say, I didn't go to UNA. I went to Osua. So exactly the same thing.
Okay, now, Mrs. Adeyemo was saying something that when those from that this few were higher placed and then come to school, they keep quiet.
Yes.
Which shouldn't be the case.
We shouldn't be.
So now, as an old student, and now that you have seen that, you know, we're all equal, although some fingers are more equal than, but you don't have to make your own finger be the lowest. Yes. What have you done, or what are you hoping to do to inculcate into the students that you have now that no one is higher than the other? You can strive to be what you want to be.
Thanks so much. I think it's part of what we're doing now.
Okay.
Then, people, not only from Lagos, then. I remember talking with a friend not too long ago. I posted something on my WhatsApp status. Mm-hmm. He now saw it. He was like, I live with this family in Zaria. I was like, so you came
all the way from Zaria?
Zaria at that time. He was like, with their brothers. Zaria, Kano, Maiduguri, people from the east, from Benin. So that's how people always come to Bushi. But like my vice president said, that's what is no longer obtainable. People within the community goes to. So I think it's part of what we're trying to do now. By coming on here, I don't know who is watching us, who will watch us. We still want people to know that, there's still Unity somewhere, there's still State Government College somewhere. And we are also trying everything possible to talk to them. Like each program we have, we always have a career talk, motivational talk. He's a very good motivational speaker. So she always talks to them. At times we send it to the school, go and talk to these people. Don't limit yourself. Don't look at the environment you have. You can do this, you can do that. Let me chip this in. There's a popular doctor in Nigeria today, Dr. Lisa. I don't know, you know Tonto Dike and so many of those people. He's the one that always implants whatever.
Liposuction and all that.
You know, liposuction and work.
That's an advert.
Yeah.
You pay for the advert. You will pay for the advert.
You understand. So it was you know, it was part of that school. He graduated from the school. There's this senior prefect of 1999 set, Lekan Aliyu. I think he broke record of 40 years in UNILAG, English language first class. So those are the things.
Now, have you brought those kind of people? Have you brought them in?
Now.
Or
now,
they are feeling
now,
too big
now,
to come
now. They are, like the doctor I mentioned, he was assistant senior prefect in 1995 set. Mm-hmm. The Lekan Aliyu I mentioned was 1997.
Is even
the
current ending of the test?
The current
ending of the test?
Not all of them.
All right.
Like the doctor is from Ogun State.
Okay.
The current CFD of Federal Teaching Hospital in Lodi was the first set of the school. So we have a whole lot of them out there doing well. So that's the encouragement we always give to them each time we talk to them. Don't think the environment can limit you. You have greater things ahead. Just face forward whatever you want to do, pursue that your dream, and you will get there. So each like the program we had, we still created time to give them a motivational talk. In fact, we invited someone from outside to talk to them. So it was able to motivate them. Like, in fact, while talking to them, I observed a definite silence. All of them were like attentive, as in trying to get virtually every word she was saying. So I was like, that's a plus. So we tried everything possible to let them know that this is just the beginning of life. They shouldn't limit themselves. At the same time, we talked to the teachers. Don't look down on these people. You understand? Do the best you can. Like our principal, the Alhaji Remi Badmo, was a father. People always talk about him till tomorrow. You know, he always want the best for us. He will cane us, he will do whatever, but he will never do, as in he will go extra mile to make sure that his school, he handled the school as if it was his personal business then. You know, my school must succeed, my student must be, you know, that's the kind of encouragement, that's the kind of thing we want from the school management as well. As we always talk to them, and we believe they will listen to us and they will do what we actually want.
Okay,
to buttress this point of the impact we have made so far on the students. Because when we started the program, even before we started the program now, for the past like 5 years or thereabouts, we have been trying to visit them annually to give a motivational talk, and we treat different topics. We talk about how to build a healthy self-esteem, We talk about attitude, how to discover their personalities, how to feed on their strengths, and overlook their weaknesses. Because we have realized that what we faced, they are also facing it. Because we are all human, and there are stages of life. You know, what where we have now is a passage, not our destination. But so many people has killed their dream while they are still in the passage. So, and because of that, it's really affecting their destination. And some they have murdered the destination they are even aspiring to reach because of low self-esteem. Because I discovered that in life, life gives accolades and applause to people who are so brave, courageous, and confident. They know what they are doing, and they are ready to pursue their dreams and goals. But when you get to a place, you are not so certain of what you are doing. Nobody seems to take you serious. Because initially, when you are doing anything, it doesn't appear to be real. It is you that conceived the idea, and you know that's exactly what you want to achieve. So if you need courage, you need passion, you need a lot of motivation and charisma to push you further to your destination. So we give this talk, and we ensure that we train them, we share our own personal experiences with them. I've never been shy telling them how I used to feel, even when I was chosen as the acting prefect, and I couldn't even accept the offer because they have you have to go to the assembly and pray publicly. You have to talk
in English.
You have to talk. And I remember the day I wrote an essay, and everybody was like, "This is fantastic. This is really outstanding. This is and that." And just a word from my essay, the teacher just circled it and asked me to come and explain. I know the meaning, as in, but I couldn't express myself and tell him that this is how it's like. I remember the word embrace. It was an embrace. Admonish. And they call one of these Lagos girls that, "Please come and tell us the meaning of admonish." And she was gesticulating with charisma, and she was so, you know, everybody pay attention to her because it was a perfect social display, and everybody was looking at her, and I couldn't even, you know, say much. I just said that.
And you were the one that wrote this.
And yes, the admonish, she's like, you know, that admonish, you know, is when you move. I said, it's not when you move. Admonish, advice. Shana said, yes, we know it's advice, but just give us a statement of how to do it. See, these are the things.
So that shows you need a lot of confidence sometimes.
I was not really sure of how to tell them exactly what I wrote the essay.
Stage fright.
Because big public speaking stuff and everything. I wrote the essay. I write very well.
Yeah.
But about something actually motivated me. And I shared with the student. When I was now made the prefect, then I was the UTDC prefect. So there was a need for me to approach the NEPA for light, the Mama Kishi, we call them Mama Kishi, those cook, know to talk to them and everything. Even if I want to speak Yoruba to them, the students I'm going to, you know, mobilize to fetch water for them, I have to express myself in English. So there was a time a labor prefect actually came and was like, "Everybody should follow me, she has a charisma and the body, you know, this thing that I'm talking about now." And everybody just followed her. And I remember shouting, "Hey, Onga, if you don't follow me, Onga." I don't know which one is Onga. Anyway, I will not say more than that. But you need to know that if you don't eat, that there will not be energy for you to cut grasses or to go into labor. And that was the first liberation I had. And since then, I made up my mind that if I can write so well, there should be a kind of, there's some inner traits in me that we should also push me to also speak what I write.
All right.
Wonderful. Now, let's talk about the issue. You said you always go there to give thought, but I think one of the things that's most common to schools and to our children these days is the issue of moral
decadence.
Exactly. So I want to ask you, what are you doing to, you know, or what do you think government can do, what do you suggest parents can do, and teachers and so on, so that we flatten the curve of this issue?
And you know, this moral decadence, it involves a lot of things, drugs, the attitude of get rich quickly, and all sorts.
Recently I started a program, you know, called Young Child Group, and it was not limited to Unity Secondary School, Government College, you know. I remember I visited a lot of school hostels and others. Davis Academy, different places. That was immediately after the COVID. And basically my push and my motivation towards the Young Shall Grow project was to encourage our children to behave in a moderate manner. Because we discovered that because of the social awareness, the media and everything, we are so exposed to lots of things. And not only that, the world is embittered. Personally, people, they are wounded and they are not healed. Some of them are wounded from home. Some parents, they don't give encouragement to their children. And some are posing to be too busy, but later they become guilty. So I believe that parents at home should also, you know, pay attention to their kids. If you refuse to train them, someone else will train them, because there is a column and a vacuum in their life that need to be trained. And the training has to be done, whether by somebody that knows how to do it better or somebody that is already corrupted. So you need to encourage them. Some of the parents don't have time now. We seem to be busy looking for our daily, you know, nicks and some other things. They keep shouting after, I'm working for them. You are not working for them. When they become something that you don't really desire or you don't want, it's something that you're going to cry and lament over. They will not end up to be like that in Jesus' name. So there is a need for parents to also watch their kids and what they watch. Most parents, because they want to satisfy their children, they give them phone, and this, you know, they watch a lot of movies online, all these things that exposes them to a lot of things. So these are the things we need to caution. Then there should be a regular motivational segment for schools. It's not just, you know, there are some things that you don't learn in school, sirs and ma'am. There are some things that you don't learn in school. So there are some things that you need to learn from people out there. I remember the period I was having a program online, and then I was talking about things that you were not taught in school. Things like how to behave, all this self-esteem, nobody teaches you. How to make money, nobody teaches you. How to develop your entrepreneurship skill, and some other things that can make life better, nobody teaches you. And how to live a decent life, nobody. Some of them go to church, they do a lot of things, they play around, they don't even listen to the sermon and the messages they preach in church. So there's a need for us to impart people around us positively.
Which you have been doing at your church.
Please do, because you might be thinking that you are not touching lives. You are touching lives. For every person you have touched, that person will also have an impact in another. And before you know what is going on, it goes round and round.
Okay, now I'm going to give both of you a test. Now, I want you to sing your school's national and not national anthem. Your school's anthem. Now, okay, it's different.
When you were in school, your anthem. We actually sang the two.
Okay, now sing it for us. Okay, just maybe the first line. The first line, because of our time, first line, and the government college, the first line. So we want you to sing that.
Unity school, Ekiti. All Saints Unity, Ushi Ekiti, created in Ondo State, Nigeria, to foster unity amidst our people. United we shall forever remain one. God help us to achieve our goals. Praise all, praise all Saints, praise all, praise all Saints, praise all Saints Unity, Ushi Ekiti. Hey, Unity School, Ushi Ekiti.
So that's for Unity.
That was the only change.
I think you passed it. Because a lot of people, after leaving secondary school, they just forget. I still remember what we sing at St. Louis. They just forget. So I think now, because of our time, we're just going to ask you, Mr. Ola Banji, now, what you education then and now, can you compare the two? The kind of teachers we had then, committed, diligent. We're not putting down the teachers now, but if we have to look at what we have now, we can see that there is a whole lot of difference now. Just in one word, do you think it is what it used to be, education back then and now, especially with this advent of social media? It's taking away the reading culture and everything from our students. What do you have
I don't think it's the same thing what we used to have then. I don't think it's what is obtainable now. I don't think so.
it was better then.
It was better.
I think it was
because
better.
Then you go to the library to read.
You go to library, you know, even you citing your teacher, you know, there was this fear in you. There's this kind of discipline in you.
You don't look up
to your teacher. You don't just look eyeball to eyeball.
Not, you know. You don't even look up to prefects. You know,
like I remember when I was in just ordinary SP, you know, I was like, SP is coming. Who is this SP? It was how I discovered I got to know SP was actually senior prefect.
Okay.
You understand? So there was this fear, you know, you don't do anyhow, you respect your teachers, and by the time you have that fear that even a teacher is coming to the class to teach, there's this, as in when the fear is there, the discipline is there, you tend to be more attentive and you listen and you want to do virtually every instructions given. So it makes it to be more serious with what you're doing. Because the fact that, if you don't do this assignment, Mr. Adewoye will beat you. Mr. Kinsami will run after you.
I'm sure you're a bad boss is coming.
You know, all those fear is always there. So you tend to be, you know, what you are supposed to do, you do it. So, but now, I don't know. I don't, like some days ago, as when we went to the, I was just looking at the teacher, I was like, it is how the teachers were then. Something told me, no, this is not what it was. Though they are also trying their own way of, you know, but you can't take away, like you say, moral decadence and so many other factors have set in over time. So you can't take that away from the whole system. But I think they're also doing their best to impact positively on the students. So to me, I would just say, I know there's a big gap.
All right.
Yes.
Okay. Well, finally, before we go on the program, just a word of encouragement, Mrs. Adeyemi. I'll start with you first, to the teachers, teachers, parents, and children, to the students. Just a word because of our time.
Yeah, I would like to tell the parent. Let me start from the parents. You know, most times we are the one that influences our life because of what happens around us. Like they used to say, some will say that's because I have a friend that has a doctor in the family. Mm-hmm. I want my own children to be a doctor, a lawyer, and this has affected a lot of people. I must confess, we attended the secondary school, we went through the universities and everything, but some of us were not on the line that we're supposed to be. We are far away from passion because at the time we're making decisions, people made decisions on our behalf or were influenced by peer pressure. So we couldn't make the actual decision on what we love to do and become in life. It's when we started growing, we now realize that I have interest in this, I think I will do better in this line. But we are far from where we're supposed to be. So parents, please try and encourage your children to pursue their dreams, their aspirations in life, because passion goes a long way. Passion is rigid. Passion is very strong, and passion will see you through the journey of the ruggedness of life. When you love what you are doing, of course, you seem to endure it better than what you don't love doing. You get frustrated where all you do is just to earn a living, but not what you love doing. So parents, please, I encourage parents out there to ensure that they allow the children to do exactly what they love to do and what they love to become. They might be young to take decisions, but you should be observant enough to notice what and what, and you'll be able to, you know, advise them towards that line. Yes, passion is very important. I preach passion all the time because I know the impact of passion. There is no overnight success anywhere. Nobody can say I become successful overnight, but there are things that you need to go through, and there are challenges, there are stages that you need to go through. Passion will see you through those others in life. Then the teachers, please, I want you to see those children as your kids, as your children. What you want to see in your own children, please ensure that you impart into their lives. There is a way that life pays us back. We call it karma. There is a way that life pays us back what we put into it. What goes around does not only, you know, comes around now, gone are those days. It now stays around. If you want to test that, you can spit up. You will see the spit will end on your head. So you need to ensure that you impart positively on those kids. Then children, please, your life is very important. You are a carrier of destiny. Don't sabotage it. Don't destroy your own destiny because of present enjoyment. There are a lot of things ahead of you. What you think you enjoy now is more compared to what God has in store for you. And I believe you have a bigger future than what you want to use to damage it now.
Right,
please learn how to be disciplined and be consistent. Be determined and focused. Then let the result oriented and your life will become great.
All right, thank you very much, Mr. Labanji. Just a word.
Yeah, thank you so much for the opportunity given to us to be here. Like my vice president has spoken to the family, to the parents, to the teachers and the staff. I would actually like to talk to the government to see what they can, how they can go back and revive those schools. You know, each time I sit back, I look at the way private schools have taken over government schools these days. In those days when we were in school, you hardly hear of private schools, at least they were existing, but you hardly hear them. You know, then Christ School, you know, Doherty, Ekiti, those are the schools we hear, and they are government schools. But go back to those schools now, like you almost cry by the time of the kind of decade in infrastructure you see on ground. So I would like to appeal to our government to look back to those schools, see what they can do to bring back those glory, to bring back the glory, to revive the glory, yeah, lost glories. At the same time, I'll talk to our old students. There's always way we can give back,
to your alma mater, school. Yeah.
You know, it might be little, but there's nothing little. Like if you go to then when we're in school, if you give us 100 naira, 200 naira, it goes a long way. You understand? So our students, students everywhere, you might be listening to this program. Please, this school belongs to all of us. The school modeled us to what we have today. Don't let us slip off and forget where we're coming from. Let's see what we can do. There's nothing too little. Let's come together. Let's revive this glory. We can do one or two things, and the school and the things will turn around for the school. Like the last time we came, the population of the students was so low. So I was surprised yesterday. I spoke with the principal. He told me they are now 403. I said, wow, that's an improvement over what as in the last time we came. But this is school that when like I said earlier, we graduated at 247, just as class. Now imagine having it 400 in the old school. Okay. So please, let's see what we can give back to the school and revive that glory. Right. We'll always be unity and unitarian will always be. Thank you.
All right, we'd like to say a very big thank you to you, Mr. Olabanji Fabi, President, 1999 set Ekiti State Government College, UC. Student, thank you very much for coming to Daybreak Nigeria.
Thanks for having
me. Mrs. Fumilayo Adeyemo, the Vice President, thank you very much for sharing your thoughts with us. You're still watching Daybreak Nigeria, coming to you from Ekiti Television. Up next, we'll be having the discussion on the recently amended electoral law. Stay with us.
Mwana wanzeru kukacha mama wa amatengaza je kuseza bakomo pama iwaje
kukacha mama
early morning
amatengaza je
kuseza bakomo pama iwaje
magoro wali
magoro waline
amu ya mikila
akujini nerero mwana mene mwana wanzeru
Magoro ali,
magoro ali,
amu ya mikira.
Akutiri nderero mwana mene, mwana wanzeru.
Line,
uyuri nderero mwana mene, mwana wanzeru.